Hello everybody, welcome back. I'm making a Thai green curry today as requested by my sister Melanie. She loves making Thai green curry, but usually she says she uses it out of a jar or out of a packet. But it's really, really easy to make, and today I'm going to show you how. So let's get started on making the paste.
So for the curry paste, you're going to need coriander, black peppercorns, cumin, nutmeg, shrimp paste, turmeric, lime zest, salt, coriander stems and roots, spring onions, lemongrass, green chillies, galangal, garlic and shallots. So for the curry you'll need chicken, broccoli, red chilli, chicken stock, kaffir lime leaves, palm sugar, fish sauce, coriander leaves, Thai eggplants. If you don't have Thai eggplant you can use zucchini or green beans, up to you. A can of coconut cream and also a can of coconut milk.
So we're going to start by putting a little bit of oil in the pan and heating it up. This part of the curry is really simple. Once you've made the paste, it's just a matter of frying everything up, adding the coconut cream in and letting it simmer for a little while. So when that oil's hot, we're just going to put in the green paste. I'm going to fry that for a couple of minutes, just again to release all the flavours. Nice and green. Okay, so that's been cooking for a couple of minutes now. I can really smell the aroma. So we're just going to add the chicken stock and the coconut cream and the coconut milk to the paste. I'm going to bring it to the boil and then let it simmer for 1 or 2 minutes. Really need smell-o-vision. Hope you're gonna like it, Mel. Okay, so once that's been simmering for a couple of minutes, we're just gonna add the chicken, the broccoli, and the eggplant, and bring it back to the boil and cook it for another couple of minutes until the chicken's cooked through.
Smells nice, baby.
Here comes my chief chopper and taste tester.
Taste tester for sure.
Smells nice.
Yeah, beautiful. Smells nice and healthy.
I hope you're gonna like it, Mel, because I'm cooking this for you.
Oh yeah.
I really think I need a bit of a saucepan. She's living on the edge. It's all going over the sides. Okay, so that's been simmering away for a couple of minutes and now we're going to add the palm sugar and the fish sauce. And also we're going to add in the Thai basil. So this recipe is quite a soupy green curry, so if you like it thicker, you can add less coconut milk or don't add the coconut milk at all, just to add the cream. But I like it a bit runnier, so then it mixes in with your rice. So lastly, we're gonna add in the lime leaves and the chopped up red chilli. Let it simmer for another minute and then you're ready to eat it. Oh, I nearly forgot the coriander leaves. Add the chopped up coriander as well. Oops. Let's give it a little taste. On the spicy side, so if you don't like it spicy, it doesn't last long though, it just lingers and then it's gone. But curry's meant to be a little bit spicy. No, the heat's gone now, so you'll be right. Okay, so that's ready now, we're going to serve it up.